Hi, this is Anne for Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to make a master artboard in Illustrator. Illustrator doesn't actually have master artboards, but you can kind of do this workaround if you want Illustrator to behave kind of like InDesign with the way InDesign uses master artboards. So first thing I'm going to do is start a new layer. And I'm going to copy only the things that will change. So that'll be these three text fields. I'm not going to copy them. I'm just going to move them up to that layer. Okay, so now when we turn that off, we can see they are over there. Now, everything else will be part of the master artboard. So I'm going to hide this, and we'll just go ahead and select all of this. And now, here's the trick, you just create a symbol out of this. So I'm going to hit new symbol, and we're going to call this master. It's going to be a graphic and a static symbol, and we'll say okay. So you can see it over here in the symbols palette now. Okay, I'm going to show the other layer. And then, by the way, I wanted to mention, this probably is a project best done in InDesign, just so you know. If you're like me, I used to be really kind of scared of InDesign because I hadn't really used it. And if you're just way more comfortable in Illustrator, it is definitely doable in Illustrator. I just kind of wanted to get out that out there that it is a better choice to put it in InDesign, in my opinion. Okay, well anyway, let's go ahead and create some more artboards. I'm going to make six of them. Okay, and we'll go ahead and rearrange those so we can kind of see them all in one pane. Okay, so there we go. We have six artboards. Okay, make sure you are on artboard number one by clicking it like this. Then select layer one by clicking this button, Command X, and then edit, paste on all artboards. So now we have that same master going across all the artboards that we just created. I'm gonna hide that, we'll just lock it. And now I'm going to come over here and click the Layer 2 button, which selects everything on this one. Make sure you're clicked on the first artboard, Command X, and then paste on all artboards that information. So now what this means is you have your locked layer here. That is your symbol. That is not going to change. We can change whatever we want here and do different things on each one. But if we want to change everything all at once on that background layer, we can just unlock it, pull that symbol out like this, and then expand this, Command E. And then we can make some changes. Maybe we'll make this green. Maybe I like this green for the outline. And this, that's not a good color. Okay. And we can make this the same color. Okay, so I made some changes to the colors and things like that. So now I can just grab all this, start moving it, and then hold Option. And you can put it right over top of that old symbol and check it out. It's updated all of the other artboards just like it would as a master page. So that is a little workaround tip I have for you today. If you like this video, please click the like button. Thank you guys so much.